Hello viewers, welcome to our channel. In this video, we will discuss on the comparison between bacteria, archaea and eukarya. So let's start. Here are the characteristics of bacteria, archaea and eukarya we will discuss and also compare. First is the membrane enclosed nucleus with nucleolus. It is absent in bacteria. Also absent in archaea, but present in eukarya. Next one is the complex internal membrane bound organelles. It is absent in bacteria. Again, it is absent in archaea, but it is present in eukarya. So the complex internal membrane bound organelles, that is mitochondria, lysosome, Golgi apparatus, endoplasmic reticulum, etc. are present in eukaryotes, but it is absent in bacteria and archaea. Third is membrane lipid. It is, in case of bacteria, this membrane lipid is ester linked and stretch in fatty acids. Whereas in archaea, the membrane lipid of the cell membrane is ether linked and this is branched aliphatic chain. In eukarya, the membrane lipid is ester linked and stretch in fatty acids. So the membrane lipid in bacteria and eukarya are ester linked and stretch in fatty acids, whereas the membrane lipid in archaea is ether linked and branched aliphatic chain. Fourth is the initiator tRNA. It is formyl methionine in case of bacteria. Whereas in archaea, this initiator tRNA is methionine. And eukarya, it is also the methionine. So, the initiator tRNA in case of archaea and eukarya is methionine. Whereas in case of bacteria, it is formyl methionine. Fifth is ribosome. In bacteria, it is 70S type. In archaea, it is also 70S type. But in eukarya, it is 80S type. So the ribosome is 70S type, that is similar in case of both bacteria and archaea. But in case of eukarya, it is 80S type. Sixth is cell wall. In case of bacteria, it consists of peptidoglycan. Whereas in case of archaea, it is pseudopeptidoglycan. In archaea, in eukarya, if the cell wall is present, that is the cell wall is present in case of mostly in plant, and in eukarya it is will be cellulosic. Seventh is polycistronic mRNA. The polycistronic mRNA is present in bacteria and archaea, but it is absent in eukarya. Polycistronic mRNAs are one that encode several different protein, whereas the in case of eukarya, the mRNA is monocistronic, that codes for a single protein. Eighth is intron in mRNA. In case of bacteria, it is absent, and archaea it is also absent, but in case of eukarya, introns in mRNA is present. 9 is RNA polymerase. In case of bacteria, the RNA polymerase is one type. Whereas in case of archaea, the RNA polymerase are several types. And in case of eukarya, the RNA polymerase are three types. That is RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2, RNA polymerase 3. Number 10 is post-transcriptional modification of RNA. It is absent in bacteria. Also absent in archaea, but in case of eukarya, it is present. That is, post-transcriptional modification of RNA is occur in case of eukarya. The post-transcriptional modification are capping, polyadenylation, splicing. 11th is histone. Histone is absent in bacteria, but it is present in archaea and eukarya. Number 12 is elongation factor 2, that is EF2. It does not react with diphtheria toxin in case of bacteria. In case of archaea, diphtheria toxin react with elongation factor 2. In case of eukarya, it reacts with diphtheria toxin. Rifampicin sensitivity to RNA polymerase. It is sensitive for bacteria. Whereas in case of archaea, this rifampicin is insensitive to RNA polymerase. Even in eukarya, this rifampicin is insensitive to RNA polymerase. 14th is sensitivity to chloramphenicol and kanamycin. In case of bacteria, it is sensitive to chloramphenicol and kanamycin. In case of archaea, it is insensitive to chloramphenicol and kanamycin. Even in eukarya, it is insensitive to chloramphenicol and kanamycin. 15 is plasmid. It is present in bacteria and archaea, but it is absent in case of eukarya. This is all about the comparison between the bacteria, archaea and eukarya. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to this channel.